I am proud and honored to speak with Dr. Robert Lustig, medical advisor to the Hyperglycemia Support Foundation, and I'd like to ask him a very important question, and he's so kind, I believe, to answer. Dr. Lustig, we have been seeing an alarming number of children being diagnosed with hyperglycemia. They're frightened, they're afraid, they're confused. Can you give them any explanation of why this is happening and maybe some hope?
Well, so hypoglycemia is unfortunately more common than it used to be, even in newborns, even in 3-year-olds, even in 17-year-olds. The problem is that different ages manifest different reasons for hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia means low blood glucose. Now, that could be either because of decreased production, that is, release of glucose from the liver into the bloodstream, or it can be due to increased clearance, that is, depositing extra energy into other cells of the body, thereby lowering blood glucose. If you have a problem of decreased production, it's one set of diseases, and those diseases tend to be metabolic diseases. If you have increased clearance, those tend to be due to high levels of the hormone insulin. Now, we are seeing many, many more babies born with high insulin, and their blood sugar is low right from the get-go. Like within 24 hours, they've already shown that they have low blood sugar. The problem is that that's the time to work them up. That's the time to figure out what's going on while they're in the hospital and when their blood sugar is lowest, because the hormones that are supposed to keep the glucose up, that's the time to check them. Some doctors just give glucose to the baby figuring, oh, it'll go away, and sometimes it doesn't go away. And the reason is because they haven't actually dealt with the problem. It will keep coming back. So you need a doctor who knows what's going on. You have to draw blood at the time of the low blood glucose. Based on those blood tests, you can determine what's going on. If it's due to high insulin, it may be a problem that can be treated with a medicine. It might be a problem ultimately that might need to be treated with surgery. You don't know until you diagnose it. And you can't diagnose it if all you're doing is pumping glucose into the baby. If you're an older child, say 3 or 4 years old, the most common reason for low blood glucose is called ketotic hypoglycemia. And that's because of a decreased production, because there's not enough glucose being stored in the liver, and so the liver can't release it when the child fasts. So this tends to happen on Sunday mornings after the parents come home after a bender and they're sleeping, and all of a sudden the kid is, you know, in their bedroom seizing at noon. That is due to the inability of the liver to be able to manufacture enough glucose to keep the blood glucose high enough. That usually requires just frequent feedings and the child will grow out of it. And that's a very easy thing to take care of long term. Now, if you're 17 and you start having low blood glucose, then the question is, do you have an insulin-releasing tumor, or are you on your way to becoming diabetic and your beta cells are trying to chug out as much insulin as they can, which can, at the end of the day, cause your blood glucose to plummet? These are things that might depend on what foods they're eating, the level of obesity, their environment, their level of stress. These also need to be evaluated in a rational fashion. Conceivably, the treatment might be just by fixing the diet. It doesn't necessarily mean that there's a problem that can't be dealt with. It might be medicine, it might be diabetes, it might go on to be a problem, but it's not necessarily a problem until you know what the problem is. But it has to be evaluated. In every one of these cases, a doctor needs to see the patient in order to make the diagnosis correctly.
We could go on and on, but that's for our next visit. Thank you so much, Dr. Robert Lustig.